God, we thank you, Father, for setting the atmosphere. We thank you, Father, for setting the atmosphere, God. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you, Father, for always being on time, God. So, Father, have your way, Father. God, we thank you that you're pouring for those who need you, Father, who desire your presence, who desire your oil, who desire your holiness, God. We thank you, God, that you are pouring like never before. So, God, have your way, Father. Captivate the heart of your people, Father. Oh, God, we thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, for having your way, God. God, we give you our yes, Father. It's something in the yes. Some of you have to redeclare your yes to God. Oh God, yes, Father. Yes to your way, Father. Yes to your will, God. I will obey you, Jesus. Yes, God. I will not stray. This time I made up my mind. There you go. Yes, God. Yes, Father. My heart says yes, God. My mind says yes, God. Yes, I will, God. I'll do what you want me to do, Father. I'll say what you want me to say, God. Even if it's hard, even if it's tough, even if it's not likable. Yes, God. All I want, guys, all I want is you, Father. All you want is our yes. Yes, God. Yes, Father. There you go, sing it to him. Yes, I will. He needs your yes in the light times. He needs your yes in sorrow times. Yes, God, to your way. Yes, God, to your will. Yes, God. Yes. You're so worthy. You're so honorable. You're so righteous. You're so holy. You're so awesome. You're so majestic. You are so great. You are so awesome. awesome. You're so loving. You're so forgiving. You are him. You are him. You are on time. You are the righteous God. You are him. There's deliverance in yes. There's breakthrough in yes. There's healing in yes. There's buildup in yes. There's encouragement in yes. But God just needs our yes. He needs a committed yes, not a wavery yes. He needs your yes. Because he knows your name. He knows what's going on. He knows what's in your household. He knows the prayers that you laid at his feet. He knows what's in your heart. He knows how you're dealing with the enemy. He knows what's going on. They put Osiah. Hey, shut that. I said it, Osiah. Yes, God. To your way and to your will. Oh, God. We love you, Father. Yes. Uh-huh. Put there you go. Yes, God. Hey, close. Yes, God. Yes, God. Uh-huh. God knows our name. Hey, close. For God knows our name. Uh-huh. He just wants your yes. He just wants your yes. My soul says yes. My soul says yes. My soul says yes, God. My heart is saying yes to you, God. Even when my eyes want to say no, Father, my soul says yes. My spirit man says yes, God. God wants to break some strongholds off of our mind. The strongholds that keep you out of the place of God. The stronghold that keeps you out of the will of God. God says, I want to bust through some things so I can have your uncommitted yes, your real yes, your genuine yes, your authentic yes. God says, I want to bust through some things so I can get to that core yes. God says, I want to bust through it. There you go. There you go. Uh-huh. Yes, God. Uh-huh. Yes, God. There you go, Father. The reading we're going to do today, we're going to switch it up a little bit. And Proverbs 3, 5, and 7. Stefan, you can play something for us. Proverbs 3, 5, and 7. It says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Uh-huh. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all of your ways, all of your ways, all of your thoughts, all of your things that are in your heart, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. We are in a pivotal season where we need God's direction in every area of our life, down to who we spend our time with. Down to where we are seeking and entertaining people. We need God's direction like never before in such a time like this. This is not a time for us to play around. But God says, trust in him with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. Because I'm here to tell you by proof, when you lean to your own understanding, you will fail. You will go by your feelings and not go by the word of God. When you lean to your own understanding, you only see half of the picture. And God says, baby, in this season, I want to give you full revelation knowledge of what is going on in your life. If you lean into God's understanding, he will give you what he gave Jesus. Jesus knew the assignment before the assignment came to pass. He knew the assignment. He knew who was going to betray him. God says, if you lean not to your own understanding, oh my goodness, but trust and acknowledge him in all of your ways. Baby, it's going to be a little bit better for you. It's a little bit easier for you. You're able to handle the task. You're able to handle the trial. You're able to handle everything that comes your way. But you got to lean into him. God says, I know your name. I know your assignment because I've written it for you. And Koronosaya, God says, I know the trials because I built you for them. God says, I know the people that are talking about you. Baby, I built you for that too. God says, in this season, either you're going to trust them or you're not. God says, in this season, trust me or not. In this season, put away in the path. Either you're going to trust me or you're not. But baby, you cannot be double-minded in your ways. You cannot be double-minded in your mindset. But you must trust in God with all of your heart. The same God that raised Jesus on the third day. The same God that helped you in your lowest point. The same God that's still covering in such a time as this. So God, have your way in this place. Trust means you rely completely on. Trust means that even though it don't add up, you still trust in him. Trust means that you're going to press into it. Trust means you are going to trust him. Trust means you are going to recite to yourself, I trust in the Lord. I'm not going to lean on to my own understanding. I trust in God. Even though my marriage feels kind of funny, I trust in God. Even though my children are acting up, I trust in God. Even though it don't look right, I trust in God. Even though I hurt, I trust in God. And a Rosaya, God wants that unwavering trust. And a Rosha Karasie. And a Rosaya. And a Rosaya. Oh, how you talk with me, Lord. And a Rosha Karasie. Oh, how you tell me, God, that I am yours. And a Rosaya. I belong to your Father. And a Rosaya. Let this minister to you. God says there are trials, tribulations, and blessings coming. And he wants you to be able to handle all three of them. Turn it up for me a little bit, please. No battle can turn me. No mountain can stop you. Cause you hold my hand, Father. Hey, in your victory, God. Speak it to yourself. You hold my hand, Father. Hey, God. There's many times I had to sing this song to myself. When days were dark for me, when people were chattering about me, I said, God, you hold my hand, Father. You know my name, God. You wrote my story, Father. You set the destiny, God. You know my name, Father. I don't care what I see. I don't care what I hear. But you know my name, God. You know my name. Oh, God, we're walking together, Father. We're living together, God. I'm trusting you, Father, because you know my name. You better prophesy that over yourself. God, you know my name. If they think they know me, Father, you know my name. Because you hold my hand, Daddy. And I don't say, you're walking with me, Daddy. You hold my hand. We're walking together. We're talking together. Oh God, I thank you. Ain't no battle. No enemy. No devil. Oh devil, we thought you said something. Because he's holding my hand. Oh my goodness. Ain't no sire. Hey God. You gonna let me hold your hand, lock and lock, step and step, move and move, twist and twist, turn and turn, up and down. I wanna hold your hand through it all. I wanna hold your hand through it all. You know my name, Father. They think they know my name, but you know my name. Oh, Maya, precious Miller, you know my name. Oh my goodness, I used to didn't like my middle name, Precious. My daddy named me that. My grandma wouldn't give him the first name, so she gave him my middle name. Oh my goodness, it speaks to me now. I'm precious to my daddy, and I'm precious to my supernatural daddy. And he knew my name. And oh, how you walk with me, God. Hey, God. Say,
oh, how you tell me.
Oh, how you tell me, God. I belong to you, Father.
Then I am your own.
God says he knows your name. God says he knows your name. Thank you, God. Thank you for knowing my name. Ooh, thank you, God. We are at the time where we are going to remember our Lord through the Lord's Supper. If you have not had received your Lord's Supper, those of you in the church, raise your hand and we'll see that you get one. We're going to ask those of you who are in the church and those of you who are at home watching us live, if you would please stand for the reverence and the remembrance of our Lord and Jesus Christ. Again, those of you who are at home, please take the opportunity to get some sacraments, something to join in to remember our Lord and Savior. The scripture is coming from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, starting at the 23rd verse. Before we go into the Lord's Supper, the scripture tells us to examine ourselves so we can repent of anything that would bring condemnation to us, anything that would be not in line to what the Lord tells us to do. Now, I'm not talking about what you did yesterday. I'm talking about what you did today. Yesterday's gone, but today, you may have done something, you may have had some thoughts in your mind that should not have been in your mind, and I'll just call it what it is. Anything that's not in the Word of God or lining up with the Word of God, it is sin. So I'm asking you to take this time to ask God to forgive you of those sins, to repent. And if you don't know what those sins are, that's why we say sins of commission, sins that unknowingly. Speak it, get that out of you. But again, just like we heard in a song that Jesus know our name and that he walks with us and we want to link up with him. We don't want to put nothing in between of us and Jesus. So this is a time for him, for you, for me to ask God and to repent for the sins of today. So at this time, if you would examine yourself. Thank you, God. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you for another opportunity to repent, God. And we know repent is to turn and never do it again. But thank you for the second chances. Thank you for the grace and the mercy that when we fall short, even when we made a vow and an oath that we wouldn't do it again, and we keep doing it over and over and over, you forgive us, God. We thank you, God. Now at this time, if you would take your sacrament out. This sacrament, whatever you have, thank you. Whatever you have, bread or a cracker, this represents his body. His body that was given to us. His body that was broken, you would break the bread or the cracker that you have. But in breaking it, remember that his body was broken for us. He said, take, eat, and they all ate.
now we have the blood. This cup of whatever represents his blood. The blood represents the sin. He took in the new covenant, which we are living in today, the new covenant, because of the blood of Jesus. Anything that we do, any sin that we can do, we can confess it and turn from that sin, because it's covered under the blood. It's covered under the blood. Thank you, God. It's covered under the blood. Not for us to take advantage of it, but for us to know when that devil tries to come our way and tell us that, oh, you're not forgiven. You can tell that devil, it's covered under the blood. He said, drink. Again, the Lord's Supper is taken to remember our Lord and Savior. It's taken to remember what was done on the cross. It's taken to remember that, as Pastor said early, our journey with Christ is no game. It should be taken seriously. And of course, God is a God of joy and laughter and fun. But don't ever let anybody or anything come in between the relationship you have with Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. We're going to play another song, and you can just meditate on the Lord's Supper and continue to give God praise and worship. Amen.
This nation, whatever they are lacking in supplies and medicine, God,
then Father, you will fill it up right now in the name of Jesus. The overflow will happen, God, and we thank you, Father, that materials are not being held up because of bidding wars, God, unethical behavior behind the scenes. But Father, your people will get what they need. Father, those who are on wait list for transplants, God, I thank you, Father, you will make a way for them, God. I thank you, dear God, that you will continue to be with them like never before. God, I thank you for all that you do, Father. You are so holy. You are so precise in everything that you do, God. And I thank you, God, that you are fulfilling the needs, God, exceeding the needs of your people, God. And God, I thank you even while exceeding our needs, God. You are cleaning us up, Father, front end to back end. That, Father, we have a new thing, Father, a new coat, Father, a new freshness. We thank you, God. I pray for those that are online, Father, those who are putting their prayer requests in the comments, that you will bless them like never before. God, I thank you, Father, for blessing my cousin, Father, that you keep her mind like never before. You renew her mind, God, that you have the angelic host around her and her family. And God, I thank you, Father, for everyone else that's dealing with a major issue, Father, something that they cannot fight themselves, God. Oh, Father, that you are intervening in the situation. God, I pray for every courtroom, God. I pray for every lawyer, God. I pray that you put the might back into them, God. I thank you, Father, for the might, for the fight, God. I thank you, Father, that the Gideons will rise up in this hour. I thank you, dear God, in the name of Jesus, Father. Oh, God, you will have your way with your people, Father. Oh, God, I pray for every family that has lost a loved one, God, that you are pouring out peace past all understanding. God, I thank you. There's a way that we can seek in your bosom, God, where we can get your help, Father. That if we draw into you and draw near to you, Father, we can get the help that we need. God, we thank you. Father, I ask that you anoint my mouth, Father. And Father, you say what you want to say, God. You do what you want to do, Father. I pray for every leader today, God. Oh, Father, that you bless them, God, that you encourage them, Father. Those who are doing what we're supposed to do, Father, I pray, God, that you will continue to lift us, God, correct us and keep us like never before. God, I pray for the first families, God, that you bless them, Father. There is a trial, God, that they have to walk through. And God, I pray that you lift them all up right now and encourage them, Father. Oh, Father, when the pastor is hurting, when the pastor is praying, when the pastor is fasting, God, God, we lift up these first families, God, that takes a hit, Father. That takes the sticking, Father. That takes the sticking, God, for those who have hurt and harmed and put their mouths on them. God, I thank you, Father. I lift up every first family right now, Father. I lift them up right now, God. I pray, God, that you pour peace into them like never before, a hedge of protection. God, I pray for those leaders, God, who may have backslid, God, that, Father, they won't turn to the people for correction, but they will turn to you, Father. Oh, God, I lift them up right now, Father. We lift up John Gray right now, Father. Father, only you know the repentance, Father. And, God, I pray, God, for those who are repenting, Father, behind the scenes, God. I pray, Father, that you will continue to keep their minds like never before, that, God, the spirit of judgmental will be bind up in this hour, that, Father, we don't have to prove anything to people, Father. We just need to get in our secret place with you, God. I thank you, Father, that we will not have a judgmental spirit on us, Father. Oh, that spirit where we are looking in somebody else's eye, Father, and can't wear it or even see the log in our own eye, Father. Give us the spirit, God, of truth. Give us the spirit of order, Father. Give us the spirit of correction, God. Strip our tongue, God, of things that are not of you, Father. Oh, God, as we remind ourselves that we took the communion, Father. We remind ourselves even when we're in the grocery store that we took communion, God. That we remind ourselves, God, when we have road rage that we took the communion. That we remind ourselves when we're not honoring our marriages, we took the communion, Father. So God, have your way. Do what you gonna do with us, Father. It's only your time, and God, that you know you coming back, and when you come back, God. So God, have your way with us. Let us surrender, God, our hearts over to you. And it's in Jesus' name, Lord, that I pray this prayer. And all that agree, give God your highest praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It is so. And amen. Amen. Bless God. Bless God. All right, we're going to be in the book of John, the book beginning at the book of John, chapter 6, beginning at verse 41. And if you can stand for the reading of the word, the book of John, chapter 6, verse 41, I will be reading from King James. It says, "The Jews then complained about him because he said, 'I am the bread which came down from heaven.' And they said, 'Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How is it then that he says, 'I have come down from heaven?'" Verse 43, "Then Jesus therefore answered and said to them, 'Do not murmur among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they shall all be taught by God. Therefore, everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except he who is from God. He has seen the Father." You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Rejected by your own is the name of this title. Rejected by your own. As we learned this past Wednesday that Jesus had a tough assignment, that he was going to have to die on the cross for our sins. We also learned that Jesus said in the circle of the Last Supper that that there was going to be one that was going to betray him. And so as we learned in that conversation on Wednesday when we tore up this place, is that God will always prepare you for whatever the assignment is. And what you will also understand is that everybody will not accept the assignment. And you have to be okay with everybody not accepting your assignment. Two things that God spoke to me as I was sitting there. Number one, with my name, there's a running joke in my family that my grandmother would not let my father name me Nancy. And no offense to any Nancy that may be watching online, but she told him, she said, "She's not a Nancy. While I appreciate your enthusiasm, her name will be Maya." And then she told me she went down, because you know it was only two people that can sit in the room. She said she went down to the waiting room and called upstairs and told my mother, "Remember what I told you, her name will be Maya." And so one of the things that the Lord said to me is that people think they know your name, but they really don't know your name. And so God says, even though they do not accept you in your assignment, be okay with that, because I am pulling your name to the forefront. We will learn from Jesus that even when he walked his assignment, his own did not accept him. It says in the passage right here where they began to talk among themselves, and they said in verse 42, and they said, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know?" And what we will find is that people will try to size us up by our family. They will try to size us up by our zip code. They will try to size us up by the things we do and do not have. And God is saying in this season, I need your full yes. So regardless of what they're sizing you up for, you are ready for everything that I have before you. And Jesus reminded me in this passage, he said, "My daughter, when I'm bringing you all to something, God will reveal it to you." You will see in verse 64, go down to verse 64. Actually, we're going to go up to 61. It says, and we're still in chapter 6. It says, "When Jesus knew himself that his disciples complained about this, he said to them, 'Does this offend you? What then if you should see the Son of Man ascend where he was before? Is it the Spirit who gives life? The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are a spirit and they are life. But there are some of you who do not believe." For Jesus knew from the beginning, who they were who did not believe and who would betray him. And just as I said this past Wednesday, Jesus already knew that Judas was going to betray him. Why? Because God had already given him the revelation knowledge. And so God says, don't be surprised when things happen and fall into your lap, because I already knew from the beginning when I was writing your story, Candace, what was going to happen, what chapter it was going to happen, and what time it was going to happen. I just need for you to understand is to commit to your yes. We have to get committed to the yes of our assignment to understand that in order for us to get over here, we got to stay with the yes. I don't care what happens. I don't care what they say. I don't care what they know. Stay committed to your yes. Yes, yes, yes. They call themselves behind the scene beings trying to plot up a plan to kill Jesus. Little did they understand, or nor did they recognize he was there to be save them for them their sins. It's the very thing that will try to kill you and take you out, and you the very one that will hurt, help that very person. And God says in this season, just stay focused. Stay focused on me. Stay focused on what I am saying. And God reminded me, he said, in order to respond to me, you have to respond to Jesus. So every time you take that sacrament, you have to remind yourself, he died on the cross for my sins, which means I cannot go back to the same thing that I used to do. If I stood in his house and said, Father, no more will I think like that. No more will I say those things. No more will I move like that. You cannot take the sacrament for granted. I watched a show on Netflix, and this woman, she dresses herself up and she gets engaged with these men and women. She doesn't care. And she begins to get them engaged, and she's an imposter, and she takes all of their money. And so the two ex-husbands and the one ex-wife, they got together and said, we're going to find her, and she's going to give us our money back. And so then they ended up finding her, and she says, well, baby, the money is gone, so I don't know what to tell you all. And these were all white-collar people who worked every single day. And then she went herself to the therapist, and the therapist said, every time you decide you want to take a lie, just put a rubber band on your wrist and then pop the rubber band. And so she said, well, that's not going to help. She said, oh, yes, it will, because every time you tell a lie, it should sting. And God says in this season, every time we take the sacraments for granted, it should sting. So I encourage each of you today to put a rubber band on your wrist. And every time you want to cuss somebody out, baby, pop that rubber band. Every time you want to talk about somebody, pop that rubber band. Every time you want to get road rage, pop that rubber band. Because God says in this season, we got to put our action where our mouth is. He says, baby, you can't take sacraments and then you go over here and do something else. You better pop that rubber band. I said, Lord, that sounds so easy. He said, darling, it really is. You just put the rubber band on and pop it. And I will tell you, in this Netflix thing that I watched, baby, she popped that rubber band so many times it fell off. And God says, in this season, I'm trying to deliver you from some things, because the Bible says, when you think you've got rid of sin, oh baby, the devil is coming back seven times with seven other strong demons, and baby, they coming to try to kill you. It says in the word that he comes to devour you. It says in his word, in the word, that he comes to roar like a lion to destroy you, to destroy your destiny. Oh my goodness. There will be people who think they know you. Talking about, isn't that Janice Pennington that's married to Rodney Pennington? What you mean she over there doing that? And God says, Elder J, you got to know what your yes is. Because baby, sometimes you got to skip by yourself in your yes. You can't let the naysayers tell you about Janice Pennington. Don't nobody know about you but you, God, and RP. And God says in this season, baby, you better know who you are. In this season, he's going to show you, they're going to be talking about you at the grocery store. In this season, you better know your assignment. Even in the midst of all of this, if we follow Jesus' story, he had to do some miracles, and he still didn't boast about what he did. He was quiet. What amazes me is I watched this movie called Chosen, and they show you Jesus, and when he's going to the wedding, and his mother said, Jesus, they don't ran out of the good wine. Baby, I'm going to need you to help. He said, Mother, why are you concerning yourself with that? She says, because I need you to fix it, because it was her good Judy's son's wedding. So she said, I need you to do something. And so it never tells me in the passage that she understood truly the power of her son, but she knew something that was going on. And Jesus, because he loved her so much, she didn't even respond to him. She says, you all do what he tells you to do. And so in the movie, it shows you all of the different steps. So they go back, and they had the two caterer people. Could you imagine this? You don't ran out the best wine, you don't promise them. And the caterer was saying, wait a minute, did you send out the best? They said, oh, we're all done with all of the wine, the good and the bad. And so Jesus went back there. He said, gather all your pots. And he began to pour into the pots. And then when they took the cup up to the head chief, which was the one who was assigned to the wedding, that tasted everything, that looked at everything before it went out. And he took the wine and he sipped the wine. And he said, wait a minute, I thought that this was supposed to come out first. Because see, they will give you all of the good wine first. And they probably do this now. They will give you all the good wine first. And then you'll be good and drunk, baby. So when they put the cheap wine out, you don't know no difference. And God says in this season,
you're going to be able to see the good between the bad. In this season, you're going to be able to see the imposter and the real. In this season, if you just give him your yes, you will be able to see what he's doing inside of you. And so Jesus did not boast about the things that God had called him to. Jesus knew fulfilled or what he had to fulfill in his assignment for other people. It wasn't that what he was doing for himself. It was because he was so committed to the Heavenly Father. So God is saying, what am I saying to my sons and daughters that you all are not committed to your yes? There are people that are waiting on you. If you gave Jesus your yes, that means you're going to respond to my direction. The second thing is that God calls and we come. God says you cannot go and initiate the relationship. When he calls you, you answers yes and then you come. So we have to understand what that looks like when we turn ourselves to the book of Judges, the book of Judges, the sixth chapter, beginning at verse 12. It says, and the angel of the Lord appeared to him, and he said to him, Lord, the Lord is with you, you mighty man of valor. Gideon said to him, oh my Lord, if the Lord is with us, why then has all this has happened to us? And where are all his miracles which our fathers told us about? So Gideon did not know at this time that because there was so much going on, God is calling him to the war. He says, wait a minute, this is the same God that my forefathers said that will keep us and cover us. And God says, baby, because I built you for the moment, you up here looking for the solution, and you are the solution. And God says, in the season, if you just give him your yes, you will understand that you are the solution to the problem, which means that you have to get in relationship with him so you understand how your solution works. You understand what you're supposed to do. You understand how you're supposed to move. You understand why everything works its way out. Oh my goodness. And so God is teaching me in this season about some pleasantries. You know what pleasantries are. Hello, how you doing? You look nice today. Thank you. How your mother doing? They doing all right. God says even in pleasantries you will find a blessing. I was having a hair foupah and I didn't know what I was going to look like today, you all. I didn't know what it was going to look like. And I went to my girlfriend's place. She's getting ready to open up an urgent care. A whole black woman opening up an urgent care. Give God some praise for that. And so I remember yesterday I was getting my nails done and I said, Father, y'all, I got to be real with you. I said, Father, don't let these braids fall out now, Lord. I can't be embarrassed of what's going on. But we at the urgent care, my husband said, uh-oh. And I said, what you mean, uh-oh? He said, look down, one of them fell out. And so we picked it up. But on our way into the place, it was a lady that had a salon the next door. And we just said hi as we were walking on into my friend's place. And then it so happened that my friend's sister had some extra hair. I'm telling y'all about the ram in the bush. She had some extra hair. And then the lady next door, baby, she was wrapping up her client. And I went over there with my unprideful self. I said, sister, how you doing? I said, these braids, they falling out in the back. And I got to preach tomorrow. I'm going to need your help. And then she said, oh, absolutely, I'm going to help you out. And then I set myself on down. It was a whole pack of hair that was almost my color. A whole braider that was next door that was helping me with my assignment. My daddy loves me so much, baby, he won't even let a hair be out of place. And I'm here to tell somebody, if you just get God your yes, baby, he will put your brains back in. Oh my goodness, they was falling out left and right. And the God that I serve, he says, baby, I know they talking about you on the internet. We won't have no missing brains up in here. And baby, let me tell you how faithful my husband is. We was tying his hair up this morning. He said, baby, it's secure. You look good. I'm here to tell y'all that I don't care what's going on in your life. You better trust the yes and amen that the God has put inside of you. The devil will have you focusing on one thing, but God is trying to focus you on another thing. You better let those pleasantries be what they are. Oh my goodness. Then it came to the time when I said, how much do I owe you? She said, oh, you don't owe me nothing. She said, you a whole pastor. I said, no, I got to pay you something. Because baby, I was looking bad. And she said, no, you got to understand, I take care of my first lady, and I got to keep her tight and right. And you somebody's home pastor, and I got to keep you tight and right. I don't know you, but I know you fancy. I said, baby, yes, I am. And she said, listen, don't you keep me from my blessing. Let me just fix you up so you can be on your way. And God says, baby, you got to know your worth. See, you think you know your worth, but you don't really know your worth. God will send people your way. Oh, the people that know you don't want to appreciate you. But he will send people your way that know the worth. They know your worth. My grandma said, baby, she ain't no Nancy, but she is fancy. But her name will be Maya. See, there's some people that will come in your life that's going to know your worth, that's going to lock with you, that's going to rock with you, that's going to encourage you. But you got to know your worth. Oh, my goodness. So how do you know your worth? Well, first of all, if you know you're worthy of something, you're going to get your relationship right with God. Oh, my goodness. The second thing is you're going to respond to your yes. You cannot wait a day longer, a minute longer, an hour longer. You got to begin to tell God your yes. God says, Maya, I need you to tighten it up. Get that health in order. Baby, I was focused. I said, devil, you won't have my mouth today. I don't care how much I walk this morning, but my mouth must be under control of the word of God. My eyesight must be in control under the word of God. You got to decree that thing over yourself. Devil, I don't care what form you come in and how many of your friends you come with. I am under the subjection of God. I don't care what they tell you about me. Baby, they talked about Jesus. I don't care what you know about my family. Baby, they talked about Jesus. All I need you to know is I gave God my yes. All I need for you to know is he gonna give me his best. And God says in this season, you better know who you are. You better know whose you are. I told y'all on a prayer call, baby, when you're in right step in relationship with God, you have access to things. And I know some people may say, she can't be serious, that she gonna tell me that God put that person there to braid her hair. Baby, I'm real serious, because I didn't know what I was gonna do. I didn't know how it was gonna look, but I said, we gonna do something. But God knows the smallest things that you're concerned about, and baby, he will put a ram in the bush for you. And I'm here to tell you today, just give him your yes. Minister, you gotta give him your full yes. Yes in your mind. Yes in your heart. Yes in your direction. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, yes, God. Yes to your way. Yes to your will. No to the enemy. No to the gossip. No to the doubt. God says, I need your yes. The devil tried to work me early this morning. He said, you didn't study enough. It won't be no good. I said, devil, you a whole lie. I got a bigger problem than you. I got to make sure these braids stay secure. So you got to find somebody else to talk to this morning. But I can't wait just another minute with you. I need my husband's help right now. God wants to get you so fiercely focused in this season. You just shut him up real nice. Devil, not today and probably not tomorrow. I got things to do tomorrow. God says in this season, you got to shut the devil up in your life. You got to shut the sin up in your life. God says, I am waiting for some of you to break through the sin that you are living in. I'm waiting for some of you to bust through the sin that you're living in so I can stand up. It's real simple. It's God called you to this earth because there's an assignment on your life. It's real simple. God has called you to encourage some people, to pray for some people, to love on some people because he needs you in this assignment. I was sitting in my office and he began to speak to me. He said, my daughter, I need you to stay focused. I know this is a tough season. And then my team at work that reports up to me, they sent me a little clock that says, you are a great leader. And then God was saying, go to Samuel. I said, is this for the church? Because I said, I thought you said we was in John. He said, daughter, just listen to me. I need you to go to Samuel. There's something I need to say to you in Samuel. And he began to speak to me in Samuel, saying, daughter, I built you for this hour. Just like I told Gideon that I am with him, I am with you. Stay focused. focus in this season. God says he's built you for this hour. He built you for this hour. Not last hour, but this hour. And that is why you got to stay focused. That is why you got to stay in relationship with God. Because, baby, the devil's looking for a small window. Oh, my goodness. Any area of your life, he don't care what it is. If you just got a small window, he gonna slide his way on through. You know those little centipedes that be crawling on your wall, and you don't call the inspectors to spray all through your house, up and down your house. I can't see it. Steph, I said, well, girl, when you see a bug, you can see then. The devil is like a centipede. Baby, he will try to slither in your life like never before. I know he's trying to work on marriages like never before. We were talking earlier this week, and we were talking about married people things. And I said to Elder J, I said, girl, make sure your alarm is on your marriage. Take that day off, girl, so you can put an upgrade your alarm system. You got to let the devil know that your marriage is tight. You can't get in this marriage unless you got the code, baby. You can't get in my finances unless you got the code, baby. You can't get in my mind unless you have the code. God says, go home and put your alarm system together. Get in your word like never before so you can put the code in that only you, your husband, and the Holy Ghost know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 2, 9, 6, whatever it needs to be. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. God says, put your code together. Because when you got your code on, bloop, the house is locked up, the mind is locked up, the marriage is locked up. Then you know how to put on the full armor. You can't put on the full armor and talking about you got the belt of truth when you living it in lie. Baby, it don't work like that. God says in this season, you got to trust him. Trust him as he's cleaning you up. Trust him as he's building you up. Trust him as he's encouraging you. Watch the soul trees that are in your life. Watch the people that will come and the people that will go. Watch the people that God will place in your life just for that moment. Watch the people. I sent you a message this morning. I don't know if you read it. One of the things as we were talking, you were talking about those people, the two brothers. And I seen something in your eyesight. God says she has a heart for my people. And I told you in the message this morning that you have such a heart for his people. He's going to show up in your life. There's a heart that is needed where you are. There is a caring that is needed where you are. The way that you took care of your grandson, baby, that is in your DNA. And God says the people need it. You may think it's a simple hello, how you doing? The people need it. And find it not strange you are sitting next to her. God says he knows your heart. He knows what you've been doing. It is not in vain. Oh my goodness. My mother-in-law's like a ram in a bush. I'll come home, I'll see some socks and say, where these come from? Baby, she'll buy you stuff you don't even need and then you think you need it. But God says he will send people that will give you what you need, when you need, how you need, and the cup you need it, and the language you need it. But you got to accept the help. And you got to trust what God is doing in your life. I know some people saying, I don't know what my assignment is. Well, it's on its way. If you ain't moving in it yet, he's cooking it up for you. I know some people are saying, but I don't hear from him. Well, baby, you better get you some oil from Chosen or wherever you got to get it from and lay it on your ears. Father, I decree and I declare I'm going to hear from you today. Father, I decree and I declare I'm going to trust you today. If you can't see it, Father, I decree and I declare I'm going to see what you see. God, I decree and I declare I'm going to move how you called me to move. Stop settling for less. Stop trusting less. Stop trusting people when God's called you to trust the best. Stop caring what they say about you. Stop caring what they know about you. All you got to know is that there's an assignment that is on your life. They talked about Jesus when he did miracles. They talked about Jesus even when he went on the cross. They talked about Jesus because he said, I know who I am. Because he said, in order to get to him, you got to go through me. They talked about him because there was oil on his life. What's the old saying? If they ain't talking about you, you ain't got nothing going on. So he had a lot going on. He was a threat to the people. And even when he went on to glory to be with God again, He had his soldiers in place. Remember Paul? It was Peter. They asked Peter. He says, I healed him in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the one that you all took up on the hill to try to kill. God says his name carries that kind of weight. So when the devil is trying to knock at your door, you can say, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who I belong to, I have the power to tell you, you must flee out of my life. He wants to build power in you. He wants to build power inside of you so you know how to move in your armor. You know how those women that are learning how to drive, wear heels, they doing all of this. Baby, you got to get on training ground. I'm going to give y'all a free tip. My grandma taught me how to wear heels, cleaning the carpet. I put on a pair of heels, vacuuming the floor, and then I got real good with it. And I was dancing and twirling around. That's why I was able to jump up and down on Wednesday, because, baby, I've been on training ground. And God says if you get on training ground, he will show you how to dance through the devil, dance through the fire. He will show you how to get through it. To get to it. So what do we have to do? And I'm going to take my seat. Number one, you have to respond to God and give him your yes. Respond to God and give him your yes. Number two, God says when he calls you for the assignment, just give him your yes, Gideon. Just give him your yes, Samuel. Just give him your yes, Deborah. Just give him your yes. Number three, God says in the yes, give him your best and he will give you irresistible grace. He took me to Paul. This is my last one. 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Chapter 12, it says in verse 9, and he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in your weakness. If you look up the word sufficient, what it means is like it is a shield for you. It is protection for you. God says if you get in his grace, it will be sufficient enough for you to get to the assignment, get through the assignment, and get to the destiny. God says if you get in his grace, if you get in your relationship, you will get to the assignment, through the assignment, and into the destiny with his grace. It's sufficient enough for you. Yes, Paul had to have a thorn because Paul had to pull his full trust into God. And God says the reason why we can't get through stuff on our own, because he needs the enemy to see that he's working still in your life. So God says, trust the process. Trust the process. So how do we trust the process? You give them your what?
Yes.
Let's say it again. How do we trust the process? We give them our what?
Yes.
So Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Father, that we can give you our full yes. We thank you, dear God, that we were open for our best. God, we thank you for that soul who have not given you their yes in their life, Father. And if they are willing to do it today, Father, that they say, yes, God, I open you up to my life. I believe Jesus died on the cross for my sins. And Father, I believe that he was raised on the third day. If you have repeat those words in your heart and believe them in your mind, you've just given your life to Christ. And if you now need a place to worship, to grow, to develop as a disciple so you can move through your assignment, if you would like to be connected here, you can reach out to the church at 513-873-7124. If you're in the building, you can get with someone on the leadership team, Elder Janice, Stefan, or Joyce, and they will help you with that. This is a season for you to give him your full yes. If you get discouraged, go back through the path of Jesus. He did miracles, signs, and wonders, and they still did not accept him. They tried to kill him with a plan, but we've learned in John that God had already told him that, baby, I got you covered. He had already told him what the plan was. The problem is we don't want to get into the bosom to get the plan. So God says, give him your full yes. Yes, Lord. And if we could just bow our heads for a moment and just begin to speak to God in your heart where you have not trusted him, areas where you're confused, areas where you're frustrated. And then ask God to allow you to welcome the yes. Everyone close their eyes. You can turn it up just a bit. And with your eyes closed, does anyone need anyone to stand in the gap from the intercessory team with him? If you need prayer, just raise your hand. All eyes closed, heads are bowed. All eyes closed, hands are bowed. All right, we're going to just pray. If you are online, you can go ahead and send me a message, and I'll be more than happy to pray for you. Just bear with us online, you all. Does anyone else need prayer today?
There should be one in the front of you or in the back seat. If not, just raise your hand and we'll have someone come to you. Those of you online, if you want to give via our Cash App, it's $ Chosen Ministries. And then we also have our Simple Give app. And you can just download that app and type in Chosen Ministries. And that's the same information for you all here in the sanctuary. And this is a still time of worshiping and giving God our yes and giving. We just thank God for what he's already done for us through our giving. And we're going to stand boldly and bring up our tithes and our offering. Put it in the basket here for the denim is holding. You can come out of your seat right now, down the aisles, please. Oh yeah, all for your glory, God. We do what we do for your glory. We do what we do with our tithes and offering for your glory, God. We thank you. Yes, yes. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this tithes and offering, God. We thank you for this opportunity to try you with our tithes and offerings. Try your word, and we know your word is true. You say that we give, that we will, you will open windows and pour us out blessings that we have no room to, that we can receive it, God. Those blessings, God, has come to some of us. Those blessings are on the way, God. Continue to have your people be faithful in their giving, God, in their service to you, God. Oh, God, continue to show us here at Chosen how to use this offering to build up your kingdom. We bless those who gave, God. Continue to bless them, God. We bless those that could not give but had a heart to give, God. Continue to bless them, God. Continue to work in their lives, build up their finances, build up their faith, God. Again, God, we thank you for this opportunity to give, and we thank you in Jesus' name we pray and give thanks. Amen. 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 Amen.
Just want to say a little prayer to take us through the week and to get us home. Heavenly Father, we come to you humble by the word that we received today, Father. Allow it to penetrate us and to follow us wherever that we may go, Father. We ask for your protection as we go about getting home safely to our destinations, Father. And we just ask that you just carry us as we go about our will for your life, Father, or our will for your will for our life, I'm sorry. And Father, we just thank you for all that you have given us today, and let it penetrate our spirit and carry us through the week, Father. And we thank you through the Heavenly Father's name. Amen.
Amen.
You all are dismissed. I do, if we have any visitors, if you would just stop over, if you're a visitor for the first time, if you would just stop over in the hospitality room, we would like to bless you with some of our items. Amen. Those of you who are, you're dismissed, feel free to go out in the parking lot and fellowship.